Hello everyone, thanks for tuning in. Welcome back to part 3 of my acrylic wash review and comparison series. If you are new to this channel, I'm Monica and my content is all about art. In this video, we will be checking out acrylic gouache paint from Turner, following the same formula as always, because...
reasons.
First, I will talk about some general specs, and after that, I will do some swatching just to see how they perform in comparison to acrylic gouache from Holbein, and then I'll put them to a test in a painting. By the end of the video, I will give you my honest opinion, so make sure to stick around.
But first, story time.
A couple of years ago, there was a sale going on Jackson's Art Supplies, and I got this set of 12 for about 20 bucks. The excitement was huge at first, but after I swatched them, I was just so very disappointed. So much so that I decided
acrylic gouache just ain't for me.
I honestly thought that I got either a bad batch or that they're simply very bad quality. Little did I know that my disappointment was due to not having researched first what I was gonna buy. Now, years later, after people kept mentioning and recommending acrylic gouache from Turner brand, I found out that the Japanese color line, albeit being an acrylic gouache, is something completely different. I will get back to that in a bit. So I decided to get this
big
tube of mixing white, as well as all 15 colors from Turner's pastel line, because I use pastel colors in my work a lot. Color range. Holbein has 102 colors in total, including pastels, metallics, and fluorescents. And if you buy their biggest set of 102 colors, which is what I did, all the fancy colors are included in that set. Turner has an array of 219 different colors. 219! Unlike Holbein, they have different lengths to choose from. The original line has between 74 and 92 different colors, depending on the region. And that's basic colors with the standard formula, without any of the fancy schmancy effect colors. Other lines they have are
pastel colors, transparent pearl colors, opaque pearl colors, metallic colors, grayish colors, lame colors, mixing colors, luminous colors.
And their Japanese line of 69 colors. Let's see what Turner says about the product.
The most highly pigmented acrylic.
Comparing both brands, the branding and the dimension of the tube looks different, of course, though the tube itself looks almost identical. It sure feels identical. Seems to be consisting out of very bendy and plasticky material. Turner says it is made of 7 protective layers. Holbein offers their acrylic gouache in 20 and 40 milliliter tubes. Turner's available sizes are 20, 40, and 100 milliliter tubes. And if you run out of white paint in no time, don't you worry, they also have 250 milliliter pouches. Now to the pricing. Turner is indeed cheaper. You pay less for an individual tube as well as for a set. Unusual pigments and fancy colors will cost more, of course. At first glance, it doesn't look like that big of a price difference between both brands. Though if you get the 36 color set from Turner, you can afford a watercolor block for the money you save. If you can somehow get your hands on them at this point in time, consider yourself lucky. Both brands are currently either low in stock or out of stock. For some colors and sets in many shops, you're supposed to wait until next year.
Bummer.
Now, getting back to the Japanese color line. As mentioned earlier, this paint is different. It has a coarse and very grainy consistency and not at all that smooth, velvety finish you'd expect from acrylic gouache. Turner created this line to mimic traditional Japanese paints. The paints they used hundreds of years ago were made of natural pigments, as well as minerals, animal bones, seashells, stuff like that. Nihonga paintings had a very special textured look and a very unique color scheme, and the Japanese line is a tribute to that. Watch out when buying the Turner sets. I heard of people having ordered the Japanese set by accident because their sets look very similar. If you want the Japanese set, the orange badge on the box is what you want to look for. That's all I gotta say for now. Let's actually go and have a look at the paints. Alright, so since I always make swatches when new paints arrive, it didn't take too long to pick colors from both brands that are most similar, so we can tell what the differences actually are. Some pairings actually look exactly the same. We will also check the opacity, so I picked three different permanent blacks and allowed it to dry completely. I applied the paint straight out of the tube and then added more water to it gradually. Starting with the Turner Japanesque, I bet you can tell how grainy it looks. It was really stubborn and hard to spread. Unfortunately, something in them reactivated the black Posca marker. That being said, I liked how it behaved watered down, and I think it looks almost watercolor-esque. As you know, I find Holbein Aquarel gouache to be stubborn and sticky, so I was surprised that it spread like butter in comparison to Japanesque. The edges are very crisp and the look is even, but things get ugly when you start adding water to it. It simply doesn't want to mix with it, and the color gets darker or blotchy in those spots when dry. It dries so very quickly and creates those ugly edges that don't want to go away when watered down. The Turner Standard paints have a thick and pasty consistency and didn't want to be spread as smoothly as Holbein, though it was much easier than Japanesque. However, as soon as I added water to the Turner paints, it behaved like a dream and like the closest to traditional gouache from all the acrylic gouache I have ever tried. Even with water, it maintained its opacity in creating a clean transient work so well. Also, it dries way slower than Holbein, which I really appreciate. I cannot tell any difference in look and feel between Turner and Holbein. Japanesque, though, has a sandpapery feel and look. Actually, it feels like gesso, and the distribution of color is streaky and uneven. Now, why would anyone buy them though? Once I did the pencil test, their existence became justified. If you are into textures or work with colored pencils, chalks or pastels a lot, you might actually love them. I barely touched the surface and the colored pencil went on easily and beautifully. You can't say the same for Holbein. In fact, I used so much force that I damaged the paper and it still wouldn't want to go on. The lighter paint would take darker colors, but it looked uneven, waxy, and somewhat cheap, not delicate and powdery. The Turner paints worked a little better with them since I didn't damage the paper, but I'm not pleased by the look either, so I guess I'll stick to using pencils on traditional gouache for now. This product here was recommended to me by my lovely subscribers. The Turner Acryl Gouache Retarder is supposed to elongate the drying process without thinning the paint, and that's exactly what it does. I have used 2 drops of water and retarder respectively, and it was in this test that I made the greatest realization. Turner works and looks best watered down. Even though the retarder worked fine, I felt the drying time was just right without it. It's a game changer for Holbein Acrylic gouache though, because it mixes better with it than with water and buys you more time. Lastly, I checked if I can lift the paint while it was still slightly wet, and as you can see, Holbein, even with the retarder and not yet dry, is like, nope. Turner had no problem with it, and I'm pleasantly surprised by the results of this test. I got a good understanding of how to use these supplies in the future. I sure don't feel like I wasted money. So far, I'm happy with Turner products, but before I give my final opinion, I want to see how they will do in a painting. Since I only have pastel colored shades by Turner, I will try to use them for the most part and to only use Holbein when I need other shades. I'm curious to see if they mix well together, and I hope the retarder will make the process a little more chill. You can sit back now and enjoy the painting part, and I'll see you in a bit. Thank you. Guys, I can't believe I made it. Many mistakes have been made that could have been avoided, but in the end, I made it. I could have pushed this painting even further, but I'm okay with it as it is, and to be honest, I was just really tired. Anyway, now to the important part. Is Turner acrylic wash really
the most highly pigmented acrylic?
Honestly, I don't know. What I do know is that they're really highly pigmented, and even watered down, the colors come stronger than expected. Let's talk about the bad things first. They have a strong smell, but it's not very off-putting in my opinion. I can definitely live with that. Then it's harder to dose, and I always ended up squishing out more than I needed. With Holbein, I usually just open the tube and then dab it onto my palette because it's runnier. Turner is really thick though, and consistency-wise, they actually remind me a lot of heavy body acrylics. And because it's so thick, you press and press, and I always squished out more than I needed. Then the drying times turned out shorter than I initially thought. The thing is, you need to spray water on it right away, otherwise they get dry or gummy like immediately. I ended up putting a mix of the retarder and water into this spritz thingy. I don't know what it's called. Anyway, that was perfect. 10 out of 10, highly recommend. And lastly, I didn't expect this, but the thicker you go with it, the more of a sheen it has, especially if you layer lots like I did. Not as much as Liquitex acrylic wash, but it was still noticeable from certain angles. Now to the good things. Vibrant colors, high pigmentation, it is cheaper, but most importantly, absolute control over flow, opacity, and consistency. This paint is supposed to be mixed with water, and I absolutely love it. I really struggled with Holbein because it's runny yet sticky, And with toner, it's just that easy. For thicker and opaque, use just a little water, more water to make it milky, or use for glazes. Now, my verdict is... I'm impressed, and I really feel like this is the go-to, least problematic, best of all worlds acrylic gouache I have ever tried. In fact, if I will ever run out of a color, I will most likely pick Turner. That being said, I still love both Holbein and Liquitex. I will use Liquitex for studies since it's the cheapest, and use Holbein as my pigment bank actually, because they mix so well with Turner, and I really, really, really prefer the consistency of Turner. I really do think that Turner is easier to use, and I really, really dig that. Alright guys, I hope you appreciate my efforts. Hopefully you learned something and feel inspired to paint. If you have questions, tips, or maybe even objections, leave me a comment. Let me know what you'd like to see next. Also, don't forget to subscribe to help me reach my next milestone of 1,000 subscribers. Let's see how that goes. I lowered my working hours, so expect to see more regular uploads in the future. Hit the bell to get notified. Is it there? And that's it for today. I appreciate you all. Thank you so much for watching, and have a fantastic day.